Timelessness is like a hyperbole, and it's very tricky in nature. Like it has many connotations to it, many meanings to it. So let's see like how it works. So there are some like definitions about timelessness, like to be resistant to change. So is there anything which can be resistant to change? Timeless work isn't actually an issue of time. It's a principle. It's a certain way, not necessarily to be unaffected by change. So as you can see, it's saying on the both sides, like there is something which can be changed and there is something which is in a position of a quality which doesn't changes over time. So let's take some examples like how it works in the like a product semiotics. So there is one philosopher, Ferdinand de Saussure. He spoke about semiotics, like how semiotics works. So there is something like on the left hand, a sign. So how a sign is being conveyed is comes in the like two terms. The signifier divided by the signified, like what was meant to be like delivered and what actually was received. So one example, with this example you can understand over here. Like on the left hand, if you see like the surface personality of the object given, like it's green, it's round, it's an apple, it has a leaf. But what is the underlying meaning which is being delivered out of this particular object is it's a fruit. Maybe I'm talking about the Apple company, freshness, happy, healthy, you know. So those are the connotation attached to the given object. So there are two things which are coming out of here, like surface personality and the underlying meaning. So how this can be used, this was used in one of the examples taken from like a Burger King, King in from the like a USA, semiotics by design. So here the underlying theme taken was, you can see over there, that's the piece of advertisement in the middle, in the yellow background. It talks about we have trimmed the fat. So the idea what they have taken forward into this advertisement is to trim the fat, and the literal adoption of that thing over here you can see is shown from that particular product over here, which is made up of like a potato, deep fried potato. Let's see how this thing is happening over time, because that was one of the very literal examples. So one very famous painter, I'm sure you must be aware of. So how does he talking about the persistence of the memory? Like you may have seen this painting. This is from Salvador Dali. So melting away anything which is anything but persistent, which is like, that means like a fluidic, very, very amorphous, which may change over time. So here the meaning which is coming out of like this painting is a very famous painting, is this surrealist mediation. So collapse of the notion of like fixed cosmic order, like nothing is like permanent, nothing is fixed in the eternity. So it's a very contrasting connotation we are getting over here. Okay, another example from like Picasso. So his own self-portrait, as you can see on the left portrait, when he was 15 year old, he drew himself when he was 25 year old, and you can see in the last one. So what is he trying to like convey? What's his like ideas behind this own, like his own self-portrait? That's like a matter of like consideration and discussion. Let's take this, how this same thing can be perceived by the like users, the visualizers. So the famous paintings are lined on the top, as you can see, like a Leonardo painting and the Van Gogh and all. But they're like a perception based like adoption by the other famous artists also at the at the bottom level you can see. So the Leonardo Vinci's like masterpiece adopted by Fernando Botero. In the third one you can see like Van Gogh's chair adopted by like David Hockney. So see the change, like how the perception is changing the originality of the like a any like a artist or any like for example like designer's perception, and how it is being delivered to the other person and how he is perceiving. So there is a definite change which is happening over time, space. And yes, this slide is a contemporary slide, like in this age particularly we are here into, like if you talk about like a product design, visual communication, graphics, apparel, fashion, font, anything, blah blah. So you are all aware of it. So how the perception is being like changed in the like today's time. So let me give you some examples over here. This is an example. You may have seen this. It's a very famous photograph. This was taken during the like a World War time, when the World War was actually over, and the soldiers were back to the shores. Okay, so they were meeting their families. So this famous actually shot was taken by in the New York somewhere. Okay, so sources you can see over here. So let's decode like what's happening in this particular like this image. So if we break this like the compositional interpretation of this particular like photograph, so there are like focal points and there is a movement adopted like in this particular like a frozen like moment in the time. As you can see the dividing lines over here, so the top horizontal line, all of the eyes of the human beings, the people standing over there in this square, are aligned to this line, and the movement, the body movement of this particular lady and that man over here who is like hugging and kissing her is like giving that fluidic moment over here, as you can see in this particular slide over here. So there is a line of sight, there is a horizon line, and there is a movement line along which all of the eyes are focused. So this is the compositional interpretation we are talking about in terms of like a expressive content, which is guided by the composition in of that particular photograph. Another example from a movie you may have seen, A Night at the Museum. Have you seen any of you? Okay, none. So, okay, you have seen it. Very nice. So you must be aware of this particular scene from there. So in that particular actually movie, those things from the past, like which are dead, they used to come alive in the middle of the night. Okay, so that was the story from that particular museum from the like US. So this particular painting, which you just saw in the like a previous slide, is placed in that particular painting. So that painting also used to come alive at the middle of the night. And these guys, while roaming around, they just entered into the dead time. They went behind like this present time, and they started interacting with the like those characters which are present in that particular like picture frame. So what happened, ki the protagonist of that story in the movie, he was having a mobile phone, as you can see in this particular picture over here. And this guy is from that 1945 wala time. Sorry. Yeah. So what happened, ki in the like in the sequence of the events, like the protagonist who was in the present time, he left his mobile phone in the hand of the guy who is coming from the 1945. So this guy was like all astonished. Oh, what the hell is this thing? So if you go back and see this movie, you'll find a lot of like, you know, this thing, like how products evolve over time and what are the lasting impressions a product can have and how a product can be perceived. For example, this is a mic, piece of mic I'm holding in my hand. What will happen if you give this piece of mic to a stone man? Definitely he will throw and hit to somebody because he may think it as a projectile. What will happen if we give this mic to a person who is coming from the future, maybe 5,000 years later or something like that? How he is going to perceive this particular piece of mic? I'm sure this will be a kind of a piece of like an antique that long ago in the future. So how the annotations of a product behaving over a different time? So is there anything like this shot? So the dialogue of this particular person, this character over here, is, hey mister, you forgot your, what the heck is this thing? So he was looking at this product with astonishment. So that was the like a factor, like he was not able to comprehend what the hell is this thing. Okay, next, another I'm coming to the another this thing, like visual social semiotics, like how the visuals of any product or any system behave in the like social setting, in the different social settings. So how the concepts, objects, figures interact in purposeful ways in order to create intended or implied meaning. Because behind any particular product, we have certain purpose. For example, like this mobile phone. Like you just remember the basic phones when we used to buy like 10 years back, Nokia phones, 1100 series, 1200 series. They used to come with a user manual, this thick. Do we still get that user manual with these current phones, Android phones, what we have? No. Have you thought of why this is happening? There is no user manual given with the latest phones anymore. Because those phones, they had the limited functionality. Well, there are many more reasons. One of them is they had the limited functionality. So to understand a phone, you can have that user manual and that's it. From page one to page last, the usability of that phone you can understand from end to, like, start to end. It's not the same case with these phones anymore. They are evolving every day. Even with the same phone, like, we 10 of us are exploring in different ways how we are adopting it to our use. So it's going very, very endless, which cannot be bound by a manual. So how a product is behaving in the social setting, how it is interacting with us, and how it is growing, and we are also growing with us. The next one. Yeah, so the signs and symbols that allow immediate understanding of any potential or insisted meanings. Okay. Who is this guy? Nice. So, what setting do you think? So, just in the change scenario, like in the contemporary setting, how the appearance of the same personality. So, again, the same picture, the same personality, the same painting, which is coming from the past, can be interpreted in a very, so many different ways today. So, as we are seeing, time is a transforming agent. It's transforming the functionality, the usability, the aesthetics, the shape, size, like all of the characteristics of the product. So it's a timeline actually taken from one research paper. Well, it's not all visible here, but actually I just kept it to give you this understanding. Like currently we are in this digital age. So how this digital age is particularly shaping the product, you know, semantics. Is there anything which can take clue from the like a future? So some of the research papers and like analysis, they explain a lot of things from the future, like how some of the traits are going forward with the design, how the some of the traits which are being generated with the help of the human evolution together. So how those things are coming. So some of these things are like foretold. Some of the research papers you can refer if somebody is more interested. I'll give the details. Okay, one more interesting example I have taken from like a movie, very famous movie. You may have seen this movie. The Gods Must Be Crazy, right? Yeah, so one of the fantastic movies of all times, I believe. So one of the scenes, for those who don't know about this movie, in one of the scenes, the guy who is flying with that small aeroplane, as you can, in the top you see, accidentally they drop a bottle, an empty bottle of Coca-Cola. In the hinterland of like Africa, in the middle of like nowhere, only nomadic people, only like tribesmen, those people are there, and they are totally not aware of the like modern things and products and anything. Okay, so how this bottle, one single piece of like glass bottle, was interpreted in a alien like a setting was an interesting phenomena to observe. In one particular scene, this bottle was like picked up by a monkey. So what happened ki during the like some of the like previous like scenes, people used to like fight for this particular bottle. They were, you know, in an anguish, like what is this alien item, from where it has landed over here, is it like a godsend? They started like you know, they kept it in the center and they circled around it. They were like focusing, thinking, they were praying, you know, they were wondering, like all many things they were kind of trying to do. And this guy particular here was trying to convince this monkey to give this bottle back, because they were fighting because of this bottle. So he said, if you don't give it to me, you are going to enter into fight in your community. So he was trying to convince this particular monkey, and at the end of this particular scene, this monkey was seems convinced and he gave it back also. Well, so some of the more like scenes from that particular like movie, with all astonishments and amusement, they were just trying to, you know, like inspect. So the point which I'm trying to make over here, in a like a different context, in an alien like setting, how a product is being conceived, how a product is being like perceived. Okay, for like whatever like a modern technologies and things we have, this may be very, very childish, this may be very, very kiddish for maybe a very, very smart civilization. Like, if you compare, dogs bark on the street, do we anytime like pay attention? We don't. Because we perceive the difference of like intelligence between us and the dogs is like immense. What will happen to a very, very like a smart and intelligent civilization, the same ratio applies to them to us. And they are not even listening to us. Maybe for them, we are at the very, very primitive level. So it's about that level. So if we conceive like those situations like out of the place, out of the like context, out of the settings, so how a design behaves, like another shot, another maybe a comic take, like this nomadic guy, he's saying, this is an interesting stick. Did it grow on a tree for like a gun? So of course, the guy who is familiar about the gun is like, all surrender, please don't shoot me. But that guy who is holding the gun, he doesn't know about that gun, like it's a gun, what it can do. Again, so the product perception, like how the product is being perceived by someone who is not familiar. Okay, so time to conclude. So how design for like timelessness like behaves over time in terms of it like uses, materials, form factor, finishing, anthropometric evolutions, and ergonomics, size, scale, and proportion. So it is very interesting to see. I have taken this example and I have collected all these pictures myself. You just see like how this particular like a derivation of a particular product which is with us, which is with the humanity for a very, very long time. And it is still evolving. See the change in the like a material. So there are some changes which we can see, but at the same time, there is some continuation also. There are some factors, some features which are continuing over time. So, are those factors belongs to bringing the timelessness in any of the designs? So, this was actually my point I wanted to make. So, actually this particular topic is again supported by some researchers from across the world. So, I have taken one from like a Caton's adoption innovation theory over here. So, how in a design environment, individuals and teams, person to person like a perception and gaps of the like a cognition are addressed and are like a perceived, and how we frame the like a design opportunity in this particular like a given scenario. So this is one of the very interesting things I have found, cognition-based design framework, CBD framework. So if any one of you are like interested to discuss more, we can talk later. So some more like a schema, like how cognitive functions work together and they evolve a design like a, you know, a design philosophy, a cognition-based like approaches to handle a design, whether it is a tangible design, whether it is a non-tangible design, in any of the forms. Handling with the product, handling with the behavior in a given setting. So, short of time, so let's move on. Well, there are various metaphysical models also available to think and develop like this philosophy. Like long-range effects on time, like relativity. Relatively, if you see like a constant connection through the effect, like causality, inconstant connection through the like a contingence, equivalence, or meaning, like a synchronicity, on the like a timeline, but like a space-time continuum or indestructible energy. So there are like, well, many poles to discuss more onto this. This is one of the very interesting topics which I thought to share with you all. So thank you if you have any questions. This one. So here if you see like a long range effects of the time, like it is talking. So again, this is in relation because time is a like factor which changes things over time, right? Like technology, evolution, even like our habits, environment, you know, our perception, even the meanings of like aesthetics, what are the factors of aesthetics we are like perceiving? Like just imagine some sorts from the like a period of like Baroque. So the kind of aesthetics belonging to the period of like Baroque, to the like modern period, to the postmodern period, to the contemporary, and maybe which the times which are going to come. So the aesthetic is the same, but the traits of aesthetics are changing over time. Correct? If I see, like if I take any example from like a Baroque or Victorian era, so you cannot find a single like surface which has like no detail. You take example of like from architecture, fashion, garments, even like a book, a typography, anything. So there is so much elaborate with too much of decoration and all. So this actually particular thing, this slide actually, this is taken from a research paper, Jung 1952. So it talks about like how the relatively like progression happens over time in the terms of like aesthetics and how the products are also getting evolved in consonance with that. But still, there are some like distinctions, but there are some qualities which are inherent and which are still going with us. Like the, remember that the slide of like I showed that water bottles over there. So in all of them, in the design language, you can see the contour, the form, the shape, the size, the proportion. It is still going on. So there are some traits which are going over the time along with us. There are some traits which are dropping in like particular like time frames. So this is very interesting to see.